Hi, this is Amy with Leap of Faith Crafting, and today I'm going to talk about the write and cut function. Actually, now they've just changed. This is the beginning of 2019, and Cricut Design Space has just changed a few things in the design space itself. So I'm going to go over that with you. So I'm just going to show you how to make these two tags that you can write on here with the with the pen feature inside the Cricut. And then it cuts it out. So I'm just going to show you how to get kind of the thicker font since that one is harder to come by. So what I'm first going to do is I'm just going to bring in a tag. So I'm just going to go to my images and type tag up here. And I'm going to search for that. And I'm just going to use this one. So I'm going to click on that and insert image. And I'm just going to make it a little bit bigger by dragging that. So for the text, I'm going to hit the text box. I'm going to write to my love. And I'm going to go up to the alignment tool right here. And I'm going to click center. So that brings it center, and then I want it closer together. So I'm going to go up to line space right here, and I'm going to click down. And you'll see those will start moving. So on the then I'm going to go up to the font. So on the font, I'm going to filter out actually writing fonts. So I'm going to click that, and these are the ones that come up. So if you have Cricut Access, you have quite a few of them. So I'll just pick one. Okay, so that turns that into that, and I'm going to make these. Actually, I'm going to make it a minus one and see how close, because these are really far apart. A little bit more. Let's do minus eight. I'm just going to make these a little bit smaller. And then to center them, I'm going to use my cursor and put a box around both of them. And up here on the align key here, I'm going to do center horizontally. So now those are right there. So you'll see on the line type, now that I used a writing font, that it says draw now. So before, usually it will say cut, and that's when it cuts them out, but I wanted to say draw. And then, once they're aligned, I'm going to click, put a box around them again, and I'm going to hit attach. So now these are attached together. So let me show you about some other fonts. So to get the thicker fonts, you'll see, let's just type in something here. So all of the ones that they write are going to be single. Here, they're not going to be thick. So even if you go to like that one that looks a little bit thicker, it still is going to be the skinnier one. If you went to like a font, let's just take off the filter. And say you were going to try to do something like this. And if you go into the draw feature, you'll see that it will only draw the outside, the outline of everything. So if you're fine with that, just doing the outline, then that's perfect. So it will come out with just drawing the outline on anything that you do. So how I got this one that is colored in, you actually have to find a font that's like a sketch font that they actually color in all these lines, which it takes a while to do. So I go to defont.com, and up here in the search box, I type in sketch. And search, and you'll see some sketch one comes up. So you'll see like this one. It will actually go in and make all these zigzags in here. This one, again, will go in there and it'll make the lines inside of it. So this one makes a lot of lines here, just back and forth. So again, if you want a font like this, you're just going to hit download. Let's see. And I'm going to click on the open type. And again, hit install. Okay, so now when we're back in here, I'm just going to save this because I'm going to have to reload it for that font to show up now. So once it's done saving, I'm going to click the refresh button up here. Okay, so now I'm going to get the tag again. Okay, and again, I'm going to enter two. And I just hit the enter button to make them on different lines. And again, I'm going to center alignment. And I'm going to go to about minus 7 on the line space. And I should go to minus 5. Probably have to change that again once we change the font. So now when I come in here, I'm just going to search sketch. And you'll see these are the two different ones. This is the one we just downloaded. So if I click that, you'll see they have all those lines in there. And I'm going to come up to the line type up here, and I'm going to hit draw. So you'll see it changes it a little bit, but it still has the dark parts in there. So the other sketch one I have is called sketch block. So if I change it to that, and again, it automatically turns it to a cut file. So I want to change it back to draw. So it used to have a write function, but now it has the draw function. So I'm going to make sure to click the draw. So you'll see that it changes it a little bit. Actually going to increase the line space a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to put, using my cursor, put a block around there and align these. So I'm going to come up and center horizontally. And again, I'm going to come down here on the right-hand side on the bottom and click attach. So now these are attached and will... You'll see over here, when I click this one over in the layers panel, you'll see that there's a draw. It's going to draw the letters or write them, and then it has the cut. So then it will cut the rest of it out. Same thing on this one here, has the draw and the cut. So now when I go to make it, you'll see that they both come up here. And so then it will, when I send it to the machine, it will cut it. I mean, it will write everything on it. So this one, like I said, is going to take a while because it has to do all of these by hand. So it took about probably 10 minutes to do this one. So when I go to continue, So it connects to my maker automatically. I'm going to click the light cardstock, and then you'll see it will show me to load the black tip pin and the clamp. And then if you need more direction on that, you hit the I information button there, and it will have pictures on opening the clamp, putting it down there, and then closing the clamp there. And then you just use your normal blade. And then once you insert it, load the mat, you hit go. Okay, so I have my paper on my mat. And I'm gonna load that in, push the arrow. And then I'm also gonna open up my pin and push this down, arrows at, and then lock it back in place. So then I'm gonna click my go button. Okay, so you see when they come out, so that writes right on there, but it's real thin, but it's still, you can still see it, and it looks beautiful. But for the thicker one, here's what that one looks like. So that you can see it actually, it took a long time. This cut took almost about 10 minutes to do. So it went through and it actually colored in all these lines in here. So that's how you can get a thicker one. So those are the two tags there.
That's all there is to the writing, or now the draw and cut function. So if you have any other questions, please let me know below. And also make sure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of these Cricut Design Space 101 tutorials. And have a great day.